Hey, what's up everyone? This is Dave from Revocation, and these are the riffs that taught me. Right off the bat, I gotta talk about Metallica. Such a great gateway band. They've gotten so many people into metal across all walks of life. I remember hearing the intro riff to Master of Puppets, and it was just one of those riffs that I just had to learn as a kid. Just super aggressive, in your face, and very iconic. So those intro riffs taught me a lot, actually. They taught me about right hand technique. You have to have a great, solid right hand if you want to play in a metal band. I really look up to James Hetfield because I think he has one of the best right hands in the biz. Just super tight, just rock solid. And it also taught me about dynamics, right? They're palm muting certain sections of those riffs, and they're also opening up other sections to add some dynamic contrast. Right there, they palm muted, and then they open it up for those power chords to let those power chords kind of punch through. This section, I thought was really cool as well, because they're doing this sort of ostinato thing where they have that low section of the riff repeating, and then they're bouncing around between these higher notes there, so you get like a perfect fifth sound. A flatted fifth, back to the perfect fifth, and then the sharp five. So playing with those different notes, it creates some cool dissonances, like the perfect fifth is consonant, but those intervals have this gnarly dissonant quality to them. Another cool thing about those intro riffs is how chromatic they are. The first riff is essentially just a chromatic scale with low E chugs in between each note. And when it goes to the F there, it's moving around chromatically on that A string. So chromaticism is definitely something that I like to incorporate into my riffs. One riff that comes to mind is the intro to The Hive. As you can hear, that riff is very chromatic. I'm giving you the flat five, perfect fifth, and sharp five, but I'm also moving to the D string and giving you the major seventh octave and flat nine. So you get even more chromaticism. And then I pull that phrase down and do another sequence of chromatic notes over F. So it's got a ton of chromaticism, and it also has that tight, palm muted to open picking in a similar way that Metallica does it on the Master of Puppets riffs. Next up is the intro riff to Hangar 18 by Megadeth. I'm a huge Megadeth fan, spend a ton of time with their catalog. I really like this riff because it's using different triads with different inversions. So it taught me about using different chord shapes, and it also taught me a lot about voice leading. So they're starting off with a D minor triad, then that moves to a B flat major triad, then to a B diminished, and then to like a C with a 9 and a 13, so breaking from the triad feel and giving you something with more tensions. Then to another D minor triad, then to B flat again, B diminished, and then to C major again. So they're using different inversions there, and they're also using voice leading, because if you notice, right, there's a chromatic walk up happening there on the G string, and then there's a chromatic walk up happening on the high E string. So it taught me about using different types of triads, different inversions, and also voice leading. I also learned a little bit about motivic development from that intro riff there. The first part of it, right, is just the chords, but then he goes into a arpeggiated sequence of that same idea. And that taught me, like, you can take one riff and do these different spin-offs from it, and that way you get more mileage out of it, you get more bang for your buck, and it just kind of enhances the song. Slayer were another one of those classic thrash bands that I was totally obsessed with growing up, still am. I've seen them live a bunch of times, they always bring it, and I think they've written some of the best riffs ever. One of my favorites is the bridge section to Angel of Death. That's one of those spider finger riffs, you know, super sneaky, chromatic, but in a different way than how Metallica used chromaticism. It's got that descending trill thing happening. And then it's got this cool shape, which has like a flat 5 and a flat 7. If you look at it like a chord, and then that note pulls down, then a chromatic walk up, and then that same shape from before, up a minor third. They also throw a cool harmony on it. It's got perfect fifths on the tail end of it, and then on the very last part of the riff, they throw in tritones. So I think that kind of inspired me to like mix and match my harmonies. You don't need to keep things diatonic, certainly, but you can also sort of play around with like just throwing different harmonies on different parts of a riff just to see how they sound. I mean, they did that perfect fifth, and then they snuck in the tritone there just to make it sound that much more demonic at the end. Symbolic by Death is one of my favorite death metal albums of all time. I think it's just a perfect record from front to back. So many killer, epic riffs on that record. Chuck was definitely ahead of the curve when it came to writing super cool, progressive parts. And the first couple of riffs of the title track definitely got my gears turning in terms of thinking about using modal interchange in my playing. Such an epic way to start that record. You know, he's using the Phrygian mode. With those cool fifths that walk down. Fifths were definitely an interval that Chuck used a lot in his playing. Just kind of adds to that epic quality of his music. What's really cool though about that riff is the second part of that song there, so he goes into natural minor. So you're going from Phrygian, E Phrygian, into E natural minor. So that's like a little bit of a modal interchange there because they're two different keys. So that taught me, like, you know, you don't have to write a song in one key all the way through. In fact, it actually sounds way cooler if you kind of mix it up. So going from Phrygian to E natural minor, just kind of like sort of surprised me actually when I learned that riff. I like always just, I guess, assumed it stayed in the same key because he's still chugging on that low E string. But yeah, when I realized, oh cool, he changed it up to natural minor there, definitely kind of opened up some possibilities for me. Finally, this brings me to Martyr. Martyr were a technical death metal band from Montreal. Super underrated band. I think their guitar player, Dan, is just an absolute musical genius. He plays for Voivod now, actually, just another incredible band from Canada. There's something in the water up in that French-speaking part of Canada. I think so many killer bands come from that region. The intro riff to Warp Zone taught me a lot of cool things. There's open strings, there's weird interval jumps, and there's also some interesting like time signature things happening as well. A lot going on in that riff for sure. It's using a diminished scale, but not in a typical way. There's these cool wide intervallic leaps. There's open strings that kind of ring together to create some dissonance, and there's some hammer-ons in there to create like a percussive quality to it. Right, so that leap from that F to the A flat there. Right, that's a big leap, and then those open strings that ring out definitely give it this dissonant texture. Then that same shape moves down a major third. Right? Again, utilizing those same intervallic leaps with the open strings. And then at the end, it goes into 9/8 for a bar or two. And he's playing this really weird, like synthetic chord. So that chord doesn't really fit into any type of scale. It's like a major 7 sharp 5. But then he also has a perfect 5th on top and the open E string, which is like the minor 3rd. You can hear some of those weird dissonances in a lot of different parts of our music. Especially on the 9th Chasm, which is the instrumental track from our new record, Netherheaven. Tons of tension in that riff. I'm stacking half steps on top of half steps. There's the low E with the F and the F sharp, right? And then I'm even giving you the open G string as well. Right. Letting all of that ring out together just creates this super gnarly dissonant texture that gives that riff a really nightmarish quality. It's a texture that I love to explore with Revocation, and like I said, you can definitely find it all over that song and in other parts of our music as well. Thanks a lot for hanging out and watching this episode of The Riffs That Taught Me. Make sure you pick up our new record, Netherheaven, out now on Metal Blade Records.